just
recorded.
It's recorded.
Okay.
What happened to the screen?
Go.
What? Turn off the lights.
Yeah. Did you?
I'm not a kid.
You don't need to
see me.
We'll
cut.
Just go. Go ahead.
Okay.
Shh.
Just turn off
all
the lights.
Oh, wow.
Can someone please turn that back on?
That was perfectly funny.
Yeah.
Oh, better.
You guys can see, right?
Yeah.
We're good. Can you put in slideshow mode? Okay, so I'm going to keep this short and sweet. I'm an environmental science major, but I've grown up playing music all my life, so that's really trained my attention to detail, and I'm just like a perfectionist as well. I've always been interested in photography, but I really got into it when I was in 10th grade. I lived in Moco my whole life, but I moved to California for a year in 10th grade, and that's when I started getting really into photography. I would take photos just of everything, really, like the architecture, the nature, people around my school. It was a huge school. I was involved in a lot of things, and I took photos like all the events I went to. So in a way, photography was like a diary for me, just like to keep memories to look back on and to help other people kind of live through the year that they had with me. So I took it just as a memory. People love my photos. I was poor, so I had a camcorder. It was a camera as well as a video recorder, and you know, people loved it. It was great. But then I came back here for high school to finish my high school at the high school I went to for 9th grade. People weren't very nice to me there. They thought it was weird that I had a camcorder, that they thought that I was recording them. They're like, "What? Why are you recording this?" I'm like, "Just because I want to, you know." But then towards the end of the year, people asked me for their photos for the yearbook, and I was happy to offer. And I would also just take it upon myself to help my peers, like my group, for their projects to make videos. And I was like really extra about it. I put music. I put text, like everything. So I'm not experienced with like professional like Photoshop and all that, but I can learn really quickly, and I, you know, did like iMovie and things like that. So yeah, I can take videos and photos, and I can edit them as well. So to be honest, I don't have a professional camera. I just have my phone camera, but I don't really care if I don't get this position. I can still help whoever gets this Dorian with, you know, their photos and videos. I can contribute. I can help edit. I don't really care if I don't have a title. I just still really enjoy working with that. And yeah, I will still help out, just even if I'm just a general member. And yeah, because that's what every club needs. Every club needs dedication, and for every member to be involved. So that's what I promise to do.
Questions for Chrissy Ruffy.
So did you take all these pictures?
Yeah, these are all my photos.
What's the point of a camera?
I don't know. I mean, I just know that was one of the things that people were worried about when they were nominating me. So, yeah, but I know I can make do. I know a lot of photographers. I can borrow their cameras. I can borrow from the library. But yeah, I did like a lot of motion photography because I was on track and cross country team.
Especially the motion capture one, like that one was one that really blew me. You didn't have an actual camera to.
Yeah, that was on my old camcorder. Yeah. Thank you.
Chris?
Okay. Yeah.
I just want to know why you want to be on eBoard and what drove you to join FASA as well.
Okay. Well, I just wanted to give back more to the club, and today marks exact, like, 1 month ago that I got involved in FAFSA for real, because Noel told me that you guys needed more dancers for Pista Hunt. And I was like, Pista Hunt's a culture show, like, am I right? And he was like, yeah, and we just need, we're in dire need of a girl, so we need you to help us. I'm like, okay, my office. And he was like, we're practicing every evening, Monday through Friday. I was like, okay, cool. And he said, you know, I needed 3 dances to learn in like 2 weeks, but I was like, okay. Like, I'm really willing to. So, and I just, like, really loved it. Like, I put a lot of pressure on myself because I'm a perfectionist, but I never felt any pressure from you guys, and, yeah, I really like FAFSA.
Okay.
So two things. One, to answer Rafi's question real quick, the point of quote-unquote camera, it's just resolution. So if you're gonna blow a camera, like a picture up to like a billboard size, like you need a real camera. But for like, so for anyone worried, like you can use your phone for cameras and you can get perfectly fine photos like you do. And then also just to address you, you say you're a perfectionist, and honestly that's the problem that I had being a historian. I did photography for 6-7 years, and done competitions here and there, this and that, and so I'm really used to like perfecting, like going through thousands of shots and getting like one shot.
Right.
You know, just submit. You know, and like you really have to be a perfectionist for that. But for historian, your job isn't. It's a different type of photography. You know, it's not. It's not. Oh, I need this perfect like image. It's like I need to document this. You know, like, for having an event, I need pictures so that I can look back at it later and say, oh, this was, you know, the time that we did this, and remember when Noel did that. You know, it's like, you want to be able to see that in the photo. So it's not about, like, necessarily being perfect. Mm-hmm. It's about capturing as much as you can. And of course, sometimes, you know, if you get a bad picture, yeah, like, don't just post it, like,
yeah.
I mean, you're still an artist, but it's like, it's, I mean, not to say I'm worried, but it's like, I just don't want you to feel like it's, you know,
okay,
the same type of thing.
Yeah,
so
it's more about, like, the coverage.
Yeah, so if you're a perfectionist, that's cool, but you really have to like meet deadlines and post pictures in a timely manner. And if you do want to edit, don't over edit.
Yeah.
You know, because that's again our problem. So.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Anyone else? Charlotte.
What other organizations are you part of, and how will you balance your time as an e-board member if you're elected, and your participation in other events?
Okay. So I think, like, I see my photos as not just a way to document what we've done throughout the year and like to look back on, but also to really attract other members like outside, because I'm on e-board for 2 other clubs this semester. I run the Instagram for, like, I run the social media for those. So I really try to get nice pictures or at least make really nice flyers to attract people to come, because if something looks really cool, they'll want to come. So, yeah, but honestly, I'm in a lot. I'm in Student Alumni Association, Retrievers for Animal Welfare and Sustainability, Pilates and Yoga. Those last two, we might think of not having anymore. So I'm trying to put my full effort into FAFSA this coming semester, because I'm taking more classes. I'm gonna be a junior, taking 400 level classes. So I can really only do like 2 or 3 clubs, really. And I'm gonna put my full effort into it.
Okay. Thank you. Next victim.